After Trump shut down the Chinese consulate in Houston, Xi Jinping has tried to play brave. But China's shutting down of the Chengdu consulate has cowardice written all over it. The feud between the Trump administration and the Xi Jinping regime is getting uglier by the day. After the US drew first blood by asking China to shut its consulate in Houston, Beijing on Friday retaliated by ordering the United States to shut its consulate in Chengdu. The 41-year-old diplomatic ties between the US and China have deteriorated to a point of no return, as what started as a trade war has now metamorphosed into a full-blown Cold War. US Senator Marco Rubio has mentioned that the consulate of Houston had become a massive spy center and the shutters that came down on it were long overdue. News reports had come in that the consulate members were burning important papers to possibly bury dirty secrets of espionage just before the consulate was shut down. However, one cannot help but wonder why, in retaliation to America's move, China has closed a consulate which, to begin with, has been unheard of, and why Beijing didn't choose any other well-known American consulate when it had the chance. In total, there are 6 US consulates in China along with one embassy in Beijing. The consulates are located in Chengdu, Guangzhou, Shanghai, Shenyang, and Wuhan. Not only this, but there is also an American consulate for Hong Kong and Macau too. Closing the Chengdu consulate was the lowest level of retaliation that Xi Jinping could have possibly chosen, perhaps after weighing in on the consequences of choosing a more high-profile American consulate like the one for Hong Kong and Macau. Here are the possible retaliatory moves that Xi Jinping must have considered right before being reminded of the ugly spat and the endgame of trade wars with the US. The most audacious one. The USA has been at China's tail ever since it brought the highly controversial National Security Bill in Hong Kong. The US has time and again threatened China that it will take the special status of Hong Kong away if China continues to tread down this path. And therefore, if China wanted to send a strong or rather audacious message to the US, it could have chosen the US Hong Kong and Macau consulate. Such a move would have sent a strong message to the US, but China could not afford to do so as the first phase of the trade deal is far from completion. Donald Trump and Mike Pompeo have previously warned China that if it didn't honor the first phase of the deal, then the repercussions could be heavy. Hong Kong is the financial hub of the world, and America, by all means, would have come down heavily on Hong Kong, and its implications would have been felt far and wide to mainland China. Keeping these permutations and combinations in mind, China backtracked before closing this consulate. Interestingly, when Global Times conducted an online poll, more than 65% voted for America's Hong Kong and Macau consulates to be closed. The high-risk ones. The other high-risk consulates that could have been closed were those in Shanghai and Guangzhou. Most financial and tech companies from the US operating out of China need access to these consulates to continue their businesses. Closing this consulate would have meant irking the business owners and America. Also, the Guangzhou consulate is the only US mission inside mainland China that sees American adoption and immigrant visas. For this reason, the US State Department considers Guangzhou as the busiest consular post. Closing any of these would have ended the Phase 1 deal and the US action would have been imminent. The readers' poll in Global Times had got 10% votes for closing the Guangzhou branch, the mid-risk one. The consulate in Shenyang is an important consulate considering its geographical location. Shenyang, in layman terms, is America's gateway to North Korea. The close proximity to North Korea is the reason why this building remains extremely important for the Trump administration. Due to the proximity of the border with North Korea, the American consulate has previously worked with local Chinese counterparts on issues related to North Korea, including nuclear non-proliferation. If China had targeted the Shenyang consulate, then America's two avenues would have been closed and it would have agitated Trump and invited further retaliatory measures. The low-risk one. The Wuhan consulate has assumed greater importance in recent times for being the epicenter of the global pandemic. The investigations that have been started by America to trace the origins of the virus will surely go through the Wuhan consulate, and cracking down on it would have insinuated that China is trying to cover its tracks. Therefore, if the Wuhan consulate was closed, America would have been provided with the required ammo to go after China. The lowest risk one. The lowest risk consulate is definitely going to be the Chengdu consulate. The Chengdu consulate that has been closed by China out of the lot was the safest bet for China. Although the embassy lies close to Tibet and the US is moving along in the direction to raise its voice for Tibet, but in a pandemic world, freeing Tibet isn't really up there in America's plan of action list. China took note of this and sacrificed the one consulate that would have invited the least amount of wrath from the Trump administration. China opted for a cautious approach when Washington DC closed a consulate that has the utmost strategic importance for Beijing. Xi Jinping sent spies and United Front activists to steal intellectual property and modern gadgetry from America using the Houston consulate. According to an American Communist survey, over 72,320 Chinese residents live in Greater Houston, which should be enough to tell you the importance of this consulate. With the closing of the Chinese consulate in Houston, China has been dealt a very heavy blow.